Hi there. Snipcart supports multiple currencies within its checkout process. In this video, you'll learn how to set up these currencies to fit your business needs. Let's do this. This first use case is applied if you're building what we could call a standard website using a site builder such as WordPress. You need to know which currency customers will use before the page is generated. If it's not your case, don't worry. I'll cover another example afterward. So the first and easiest way to define your default cart currency is by using the data currency attribute. It is set on the Snipcart div tag alongside your API key. As you can see, this change will reflect in the cart automatically. You can also define different prices on your products depending on the currency. To do so, use a JSON object in the data item price attribute instead of a single number. In this example, I'll specify the amount in euro, Canadian dollars, and US dollars. Then, depending on the currency set in the data currency attribute, you'll see the price being adjusted properly. As I mentioned earlier, the first example works great if you already know which currency your customers are paying with. However, you might want to allow them to decide the currency they want. Let's add a dropdown in the header of the site, highlighting different supported currencies. For this to work, make sure that the data currency attribute is not present. Then, in a script tag, let's add some JavaScript. We'll use the snipcart.ready event to make sure our API is ready and available. We'll enable the cart currency to be updated when the dropdown value is changed using the snipcart.api.session.setCurrency method. As you can see, changing the currency via the dropdown now works. However, the default selected value doesn't match the actual cart currency. Let's address that. Create a function named updateSelectedCurrency, which will retrieve the currency from the state. Then, set the dropdown value in JavaScript. This method will be called whenever there's a change in the state using the store available via our SDK. Refresh the website one last time, and you'll notice that the default selected currency now works fine. These steps will set up the client side of your multi-currency store. You now need to add which currency your store supports in the merchant dashboard. Open up your dashboard and go to Regional Settings. From there, add all supported currencies. Note that the first currency you set here will be the default one used by Snipcart on your site. And that's it. To configure and customize your cart and checkout flow further, please refer to our documentation.